Thank you, Mr. Gururaj, for joining us.
Great.
Do you think the new entrepreneur of today is afraid to take risk and go for the hard things?
Yeah, I think, listen, there are different types of entrepreneurs and there are different types of problems. What may seem to you a simple problem may actually be a hard one in essence. What may be a very hard problem on the face of it, if you find the right solution, may turn out to be quite a simple solution, right? So I think, you know, what they should do is they should really try and focus on pain that the consumer will have, make sure that they're really solving some fundamental problem. I think resist the temptation to be the sixth one in the same segment. It might be okay to be the second or the third, but once you get past that point, it's a little more iffy. Are you really adding value? Are you really bringing something new to the table? Are you going to be able to do something very different than what others have already done, right? So I think that's a very important aspect you should keep in mind. I think in the current environment, it's a little bubbly. Lots of things are getting funded. Lots of investors are putting money into parallel startups in some sense that are similar to what others have funded. But I think that wave will recede, you know. And at that point, those that are solving real deep problems will see traction and be able to kind of bubble up over the noise.
You meet a lot of young entrepreneurs, and how would you describe a typical quintessential young Indian entrepreneur?
I think they're very ambitious now. They have, you know, in some sense, broken down any barriers they were to the risk of entrepreneurship. The stigma of failure is gone. So in that sense, they are quite fearless, I think. But at the same time, they're very young still. For the most part, it's still a maturing ecosystem. So I think, you know, we will see many emerge from the current ecosystem that will do very well, but not in the hundreds, let's say. It might be in the few dozens, right? But I think the next cycle around would be even more exciting because all of those folks who try now and maybe fail will come back for another try. I think it's going to be very addictive.
Many of our entrepreneurs, engineers are building apps today, but do you think they are ready to build business?
Yeah, I think, you know, obviously the threshold to building an app is relatively low. So, you know, two people with a couple of laptops and a good idea, even one can build an app on their own. But converting an app into a business is a very different beast, right? As you well said. I think, you know, we've got to be prepared that you've got to think through a fundamental business model. You've got to think through sustainability. It shouldn't be something that's just ephemeral if you're thinking of building a business. Now, there's nothing wrong with you building an app that may be a good feature. You can even make a few $100,000 on it by uploading it to the App Store and having a whole bunch of people download it, pay you a couple of bucks each. You know, it may be a game, it may be some kind of a little nifty utility. There's nothing wrong with that, you know, and that might well then seed your next venture, right? So there's always hope, but make sure you're doing something that's absolutely delightful in terms of user experience, is differentiated in terms of its use case, right? And is defendable in terms from competition, right? I think if you do that, you'll have a good shot. It's a hard world out there, trying to raise a mobile app company. And, you know, so good luck to all those that want to try, because there's a big prize if you can succeed.
Thank you so much, Mr.
Okay, Gururaj. Great. Thank you.
Why did you decide to move from, auto rickshaw hailing app to doing deliveries through auto rickshaw? It's a very interesting model.
So actually, we were hailing auto rickshaw rides, really. So and people automatically started doing this. Merchants would start, you know, ordering deliveries. Customers started ordering deliveries. The reason is simple. The ticket size makes sense.